Vaigunno Kito Kolito Paishunno Brono Pirito Dainar Nabe Nemagna Hamsi Chaitanya Vaidyam Asraye. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad, Gaudiya Gostibati, actually told that preaching can be done both way. One is negative way, another is positive way. Gaudiya Gostibati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad told, preaching can be done both way. One is negative way, another is positive way. Negative preaching is very fast. Negative preaching is very fast, and the result is very dangerous. But positive preaching, procedure is very slow. Positive preaching, procedure is very slow, yet very concrete. You can get very excellent result out of that. Actually, you can remember Agasur, Bakasur, Kangsa, Jarasandha, Sisupal, they are actually preacher. Not preacher. Actually, they are preaching for Krishna, but negative way. Very massive way. If Kamsa is not there, Jarasandha is not there, if Sisupal not there, who can know the excellent glories of Krishna? Negative way of preaching, actually. But we Gaudiya, we are interested about positive preaching. Actual preaching, exact preaching, to the point preaching, done by all Brajavasis, Gopikas. But that preaching is so slow, nobody can understand. Very slow procedure, unique procedure. Gradually, someday you can know. Very excellent procedure. Now, actually, point is that I started with the slog, Vaigunno Kito Kolito, Paishunno Brono Pirito, Dainar Nabe Nemagna Hamsi Chaitanya Vaidyam Asraye. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, from the core of heart, speaking this way, very humble way. Because all our Guru Varga, they want to teach us preaching. I can come to the actual point, gradually. Actually, all our Guru Varga, and especially Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, is speaking this word from the core of heart. Very humble attitude, Trinadopi, is speaking this way. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, actually, I am full of, you know, bad qualities. I am full of bad qualities. And it is just like bookworm, you know, bookworm. If you keep one book, one place for 15 years, 20 years, some kind of, you know, worm coming and cutting that book. And sometimes it happens so, if you open the book and find you cannot read anything, all cut it. It's very dangerous. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami want to compare his bad qualities, all innumerable bad qualities. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking this way. I have countless bad qualities, just like bookworm, Vaigunno Kito Kolito. My real self already, you see, there, you know, cutting as if it is nothing there. I am just, you know, lost in this material world. What to speak about my, you know, pathetic condition? What to speak about my pathetic? I am very fallen soul. This way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Paishunno Brono Purito. Vaigunno Kito Kolito, Paishunno Brono Purito. and all beastly qualities are going to eat me up, grabs me. Beastly qualities. I don't have any qualities, but at all I have beastly qualities. All those beasts they have, that kind of qualities I pose, I have. Vaigunno kito kolito paishunno brono purito doinar nave nivagdaham si chaitanna vaidyam asuray. Now, I am fallen into the soul of doinno. Because I realize my condition, pathetic condition, no other way. So, I am going to jump into the ocean of doinno, you know. Dainanavanimagnaham, chaitanya vaidyavasvaya. So I want to take shelter of that Ayurvedic doctor, whose name is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You can remember, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can solve any problem. Not only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, any parsad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I was speaking there. Prabhupada speaking. Externally, you can find my Gurudev is not educated. Uneducated, you can find. But believe me or not, my Guru Maharaj can solve, Paramahansa Gurudev can solve any problem pertaining to this 14th world. Externally, you cannot find, there's no education with my Guru Maharaj, Paramahansa Gurudev, but he is versed in spiritual, you know, line. So elevated, Paramahansa, that he can solve any problem pertaining to his 14 worlds. Any problem can solve, flawless solution. My Guru Path Padma, Paramahansa Gurudev, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj can find flawless solution to any problem pertaining to the spirit. This is the excellency of my Guru Maharaj. So what to speak about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Supreme Lord, actually. So, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, first hand, want to teach us the humble attitude. And one thing I like to speak, that Prabhupada told, if there is no acharan, without acharan, any kind of preaching, if you find going on in this material world, it is one kind of karma. Acharan bihin prachar karmer antargato in Bengali. Without acharan, any kind of preaching going on in this, you know, world, is one kind of karma, material karma. Follow? Why I want to pick up this point? Because very important point. Prabhupada actually speaking, you can remember, Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangha Pangasta Parashadam. This slok you heard, I think you heard many times. Full slok I don't need. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangha Pangasta Parashadam. Krishna Varnam, this slok if I discuss, it will take long time during Gaurpunim time. I like to discuss this point, very nice. But here, important point, Krishna Varnam, Tisha Krishna, different from different angle, I can try to discuss this sloka, very nice. But today my topics is totally different. So I like to switch over to other point, actually. So actually, Krishna Varnam, Tisha Krishna, but Sangha, Sa Ango, Sango Pango Parsadam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Supreme Lord, is Supreme Lord, Swayamrup Bhagavan. Swayamrup Bhagavan means all avatara coming from him. There is no cause of this Supreme Lord Krishna, Nanda Nandan Krishna. There is no cause. Final cause of all causes is ultimate goal, Krishna, Nanda Nandan Krishna. So actually he is Supreme Lord, not only Supreme Lord, actually Swayam Rup Bhagavan. Swayam Rup Bhagavan. So I already told, try to understand the Bani Sarup of Guru Varga. Those who are Vaishnavas, they have their excellent in Darshan. They have their excellent Darshan. Actually, Prabhupada used to speak two terms, you can remember. Akshaya and Adhakshaya Darshan. Prabhupada used to speak very often these two terms, actually. One is Akshaya Darshan, another is Adhakshaya Darshan. Akshaya Darshan means your darshan is material darshan. You always try to see by your own eyes. This is called actually Akshaya Darshan, material darshan. Anywhere you look, anything you look, you can find matter, matter and matter. Nothing except matter you can realize. That is the blind condition. Which you can remember, Prahlad Maharaj used to say in 7th Kanta, Andha yathandhai rupaniyamanam teyopi sichatanta murudham nivadhya. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, a blind can never be guided by another blind. How possible? If at all you find one blind guiding another blind, both of them going to meet with an accident. No way. Big danger. Andha yathandhai rupaniyamanam teyopi sichatanta murudham nivadhya. Urudham nivadhya mean a Sanskrit word actually, Urudamni, Uru means Puru, very strong bondage. Urudamni, Damni achi, is rope, strong bondage. Urudamni Badhya. Damna Olukhale Badhya, Dam Udaraha. Dam Udare Yaso Sa Dam Udaraha. This is the meaning actually. So here Prahlad Maharaj want to speak this way, that actually Andha yathandhai rupaniyamanam teyopi sichatanta murudam nivadhya. They are tightly bonded by one rope. Rope means the bondage of Maya. Is one come darshanic, you know, excellent, you know, word. Udam nivadhya was a strong bondage by the three modes of nature. They are all bonded soul. How you can expect they can guide you properly? Maybe he memorized so many volumes of books he can memorize. Maybe his memory is very high. He is an excellent philosopher. So what? We are less interested to hear about any philosophy, dry philosophy. So this is no point actually. We want to hear about the direct feeling, what I inherit from my Guru Path Padma. Who is interested to hear your lecture? Who? Dry philosophy lecture? Cannot give you any benefit. We are interested about direct realization which I receive from my Guru Path Padma. That the thing I like to share you all, that is called actual preaching. The other day, I was discussing this point. The other day, in Siya Palace in Puri, Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj's place, I was discussing this place. I was bound to speak this way, that in the lineage of Gaudiya, in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, Thinadopi Swanich is a common thing, very common thing. It's quite natural. I was speaking this point. Day by day, I like to explain this point. How, what is the excellency of this word? So I already told that day, we are not ready to bow down in front of anybody. we are puffed up. Already I told Prabhupada speaking these two things, actually, akshaja and adhakshaja. Adhakshaja. Akshaja means material darshan. Material darshan. You cannot see them. You are in them, but you cannot see them. You can find some hotel, you know, so many public running, doing all nonsense. You can find this. But Bhaktivinod Thakur, as soon as reaching Dhamma, he find transcendental feature of Dhamma. He can see everything, what is what. Some devotee put a question in front of me the other day. I mean, 15, 20 years ago maybe. One brahmachari from which place, I don't know. Red cloth. Why Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj came here in Gaurdham, living Vrindavan? I can answer you in a long way, but very short answer I like to give. There is so many things, so many causes, vital causes. Out of that one vital cause is that Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj receiving, getting instruction from Gaurhari that you go there and try to discover my birthplace, advent place. Vital cause. So many causes I can prove. And about Gaurkishat Das Babaji Maharaj, you can also Ashtakam, you can find. Gauro Bajabhedo Vishishta Program. Gauro Bajabhedo. Gaurdham and Vrindavandham non different. That feeling is always there with one Rasik Acharya. Always, every time. Gaurdham and Vrindavandham non-different. Gaurdham is more important in the sense is actually Gaurdham going to excuse us all the time. Kama mai. Kama mean excuse. All the time Gaurdham want to bless us. They Gaurdham. Gaurdham Tattva is Balaev Tattva. Balaev Tattva. Without the blessing of Nityananda Balaram, nobody can go for preaching. Nobody can go for preaching. I was speaking this way that in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, Trinadapi Sunich is quite natural. And actually, Trinadapi Sunich, this Baba, is so important, vital Baba. Without that, we cannot expect the life of a Vaishnava. And nobody can go for preaching without getting this kind of Trinadapi Baba. All our Guru Varga preaching excellent way, they are having Trinadapi Baba. All the time they are having Trinadapi Baba. Actually, point is that Krishna Varnam Tisha Akishnam Sango Pango Astaparshadam. Sangha means I already told that the transcendental feature of Gurudev you can clearly see provided you are 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Sadguru Vaishnava. You can realize this is the Bani Sharup of Gurudev. This is the Bani Sharup of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is the Bani Sharup of Prabhupada. This is the Bani Sharup of Keshav Goswami Maharaj. Oh, they have some or other kind of speciality they have. But anyway, you can see the Bani Sharupa or Guru Varga. Provided you are enjoying 100% Kripa or all Guru Varga without that. Because self-effulgence thing, you cannot apply your brain, is beyond human comprehension. Night 2 o'clock, you cannot try to see sun god. It's impossible. You can have a light, big light, search light, how you can search, but you cannot see. Morning time, sun god can appear in the sky. We can see both sun god, and by the mercy of sun god, we can see what is what. What is what there in this material, everything we can. See, akhija darshan means material darshan. All material people, and those who are kanishta bhakta, they are all akshaja darshan. They have still today they are not having that kind of fine darshan. They are not having that kind of fine darshan, they don't have. They only they can see blood and flesh, they can see stool and urine. One so-called devotee coming from Vrindavan in and paying dandavat in front of Guru Padma and paying dandavat, Guru Maharaj. Maharaj, I am coming from Vrindavan. Oh, really? Ah, very nice. Actually, all roads of Vrindavan full of stools. Yes, so dirty. Guru Maharaj laughing. A monkey always taking speck. Oh, so problem. We cannot walk properly. After he gone, Guru Maharaj laughing in front of me. Look, my son. He is going to Vrindavan to have a nice darshan. This kind of darshan we have. Mayapur Dham is full of prosquarter, full of, you know, hotel and hostel, everything, all business going all around. Gaudiya Baba says, where you find business? I find no business. Dham is Dham, clean and clear vision. It's called Adokshada Darshan. Adokshada Darshan means, Adokshada means, with permanent darshan, clear darshan. I mean, what is what? That is clear. Why I am clear? Speaking to clearly speak about the qualities of a preacher. I am going. There's for 2-3 days I am going. You know. Adakshaya darshan actually means clear darshan, as it is. As it is darshan, unique darshan. Transcendental darshan. Jiva Goswami Pad giving explanation of this word, adhakshaja. Adhakshaja, Jiva Goswami Pad explaining which way, Jiva Goswami Pad speaking, adhakrita akshaja jnanam tatha indriya jnanam jeno iti adhakshaja. Jiva Goswami Pad in Sandarbha giving clear, you know, conception about adhakshaja darshan. Adhakshaja means, who is Adakshaja? Adakshaja is Supreme Lord. I already told, Supreme Lord can reserve the right of not being exposed to his sense organ. I already told many times. Vaishnava also, Hariguru, Vaishnava, Dham, they also can reserve the right of not being exposed. Because Mahamaya and Jogamaya, Mahamaya cannot allow you to get in touch with Dhamma. In that case, you can get facility. But anyway, if you are going to get some kipa of Guru Vaishnava, then you can get some Dhamma kipa. Dhamma kipa, Dham is more liberal. Which Bhagavan cannot excuse, the Dhamma can excuse you. This is Dhamma Tattva, is Baladev Tattva. So you know, adhakrita akshaya jnanam tatha indriyaja jnanam jena iti adhakshana. It's more clear. Actually, adhakya akhaja jnanam and a Supreme Lord, actually going to, you know, push the material darshan down. Push, kick your material, your effort of material darshan, then adhakshaja vastu, Supreme Lord going to kick your effort down. Adhakya akshaja jnanam, akshaja means real material gyan, material darshan, which you can try, I mean, through your sense organ, material sense organ. With ear, material ear, you like to hear material word, all material sounds. With eyes, you like to see material beauties. You know, this way, you want to engage all your sense organ, material sense organ, to get some idea about one transcendental thing, which is not at all possible. Aprakita vastu kabu, prakita gochar nahi. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, this written, transcendental things can never be realized by material darshan, by material sense organs. You cannot realize. So, Adakshaja Darshan and Akshaja Darshan, and now you can realize actually. So, actually, what I mean to say, Prabhupada speaking this word, that if you are failure to discover, to understand the Bani Sharup of Gurudev, then your Guru Darshan is not complete as yet. You have taken Dikha, right? But Dikha is a long procedure. I already discussed this point many times. Diksha is a long procedure to get your perfection. Suppose is a unique thing. If somebody, some devotee, you know, going to get perfect kripa at the time of Diksha, that is an exceptional thing. At the time of Diksha, if any, you know, Jivatma, if you find, suppose at the time of Diksha, at this instant he is going to get kripa. That's almost rare. That is in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is written, Diksha Kale Shishya Kare Atma Samarpan, Sei Kale Krishna Tare Kare Atma Sham. Diksha Kale, the time of Diksha, when submission is complete, and if you are enjoying full kripa of Gurudev, then Diksha, you know, very nice. Then you can get full kripa of Gurupad Padma, is rare actually. That's why we need to take Diksha. I mean, Harinam also, sometimes you can find somebody like Prabhupada. Prabhupada getting Harinam from Bhaktivinod Thakur. Prabhupada getting Harinam from Bhaktivinod Thakur, instant Bhaktivinod Thakur give order to receive Kurmadev, which is rare. Kurmadev is salogram. Without Diksha you cannot receive, but it's a rare case. Because Diksha is transcendental, you know. Prabhupada coming. But at the time of birth, you can find transcendental upabit, you know, skarthe. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction to Prabhupada to worship Kurmadev. Whereas he only having Harinam. Through Harinam, we can get everything. And you will have to realize the sarup of Harinam. Because before going for preaching, I am discussing everything all in details. And Harinam itself can give you everything, complete. Harinam itself complete. Harinam is equal to Hari. Krishnanam is equal to Krishna. Harinam or Krishnanam can give you everything. Itself complete. But still, our Guru Varga giving us Diksha to take preparation. What kind of preparation? To cut material bondage. Gayatri can help you to cut material bondage. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving explanation, sometime you can find some special case. Actually, through Harinam you can get everything. Even Krishna Prema Nitya Seva. No need of Diksha. When? The excellent thing. Not applicable for all. Sometime it is applicable for somebody. Diksha Purascharan Vidhi Apekshana Kare. Diksha Purascharan Vidhi Apekshana Kare, Jivhas Parse Achandale Udhare. Maybe you are from Lokas, from Chandal, or, you know, Shudra, Chandal, you know. Still, if Harinam can touch your tongue, it can deliver you instant. When? Prabhupada speaking, if you have 100% faith in Harinam, that is one special case. When you have 100% faith in Harinam, that Harinam can give you everything. In that case, Harinam can give you everything. But usually, it is not the case. Usually, it is not sin. That's why, first of all, Guru Bhargo giving us Harinam to practice and to realize the feature of Harinam and Hari, His Dhamma, Nama, we are given Diksha. Through Diksha, we can go, get realization day by day and complete Diksha. Actually, when we leave body, there also we are initiated by Aprakita Seva Diksha. There is Aprakita Seva Diksha. Here is month of Diksha, there is Seva Diksha. If you leave your body, you can go there, you are also. Haridas Thakur speaking in front of that harlots, amen, Lakshahira. Actually, I am initiated every day. But Harinam, 3 lakhs Harinam, what to do? Okay, today my name is not complete, what to do? Excuse me. Tomorrow you come, I can fulfill your heart. So Haridas Thakur speaking, every day I am initiated by Harinam. Initiation, long procedure, it need scientific explanation of this diksha, without which you cannot, you know, appraise, you know, Dhamma, Nama, you cannot get in contact. Is now what Prabhupada want to speak in front of our Guru Varga. I mean, Prabhupada speaking, Krishna Varnam Tisha Akishnam, Sanga Pangasta Parshadam, Sa Anga. Anga mean, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Bhagavan Sri Krishna, if you want to mean Anga, Anga mean transcendental body, transcendental body. So actually, transcendental body of Krishna, Gauranga Mahaprabhu is all the same, transcendental in nature. Sanga. Sanga mean, Prabhupada explaining this word. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to give you some advice, I mean, Sankirtan Adi advice. And all advice by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is equal to his transcendental body. Shabda Brahma is equal to Parabrahma. Shabda Brahma is equal to Parabrahma. Follow? Shabda Brahma is equal to Parabrahma. So, if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking some Chaitanya Bani, is actually is transcendental sound vibration equal to the transcendental feature of Supreme Lord. Sanga. Upanga. Upanga means what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving some advice, actually, according to the advice of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, those who are going to preach in front of all bonded show, all over the world you find, but actual preaching is very rare. I want to clarify this point. Actually, Upanga means those who are going to preach Chaitanya Vani perfect way. They actually Upanga. Swango Panga, Upanga. Upanga means those who are going to preach. As per the advice of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are going to preach, they are Upanga. And Astha, what do you mean Astha? Weapon. What do you mean by weapon? Weapon mean? Are the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's weapon. First of all, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took bath, he wanted to give us Harinam. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. That baby stopped crying. So as soon as Prabhu took birth, started preaching of Harinam. And on you can know everything, that what kind of preaching was done by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And massive preaching was done. Though he is Supreme Lord, preaching is the, you know, preaching should be done by devotees. But we see Supreme Lord in the form of devotees preaching. So Astra mean, weapon mean, actually, weapon mean, all this teaching, Chaitanya Shiksha. Chaitanya Shikshamritam is a weapon. Chaitanya Shikshamritam is one kind of weapon through which you can cut all material bondage of this material world. You can readily, easily, you can cut. So this is called actually weapon. Without this weapon, you cannot go for preaching. Not possible, actually. Impossible. If you go for preaching, before that, you must understand all those points. But I want to discuss, and parsha, sangha panga, asta parshadam. Asta mean weapon, are the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu itself, one kind of weapon. You see, by the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we can cut all bondage of all those bonded souls. And Parshad, I already explained, there also, Parshad means those who want to implement the teachings of Chaitanya, implement Sri Chaitanya Manavishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale, Keno Bhutale, by Guru Vargena. Guru Vargena, Bhutale. Bhutale means the material earth on the surface. And those by our Guru Varga, those who are Parsad, everybody not Parsad, those who are Parsad, how, what is the symptom on those Parsad? You can find they want to implement that, you know, the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to do, all can be done by our, you know, Parshad, Gaur Parshad, Gauranga Parshad actually. Now, before going to this vital point, I like to explain this point, that why Bhaktivinoda Thakur always advising us that Mat Mandi Dalan Bari Nakaro Prayas. Don't try to make temple, you know, and all nice buildings, everything. Matmandi Dalan Bari Nakaro Prayas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur advising us this way. Whereas, you know, actually, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada established in 64 maths all over the world. Whereas we get the advice Bhaktivinoda Thakur, from Bhaktivinoda Thakur we are getting this advice, Matmandi Dalanbari Nakuro Prayas. Don't try to make, you know, Mat Mandir, you know, Mat, big, big temple and everything, and building, nice building, construction. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, advising us this way. Whereas we find that Prabhupada making 64 temples all over the world. I was discussing in Puri also this point, that Sharadindu Rai, one big educated, you know, man, is coming in front of Prabhupada and speaking this, you know, discourse going on, and speaking, Prabhupada, within this short period of time, you are establishing actually, that time 50 mots was established, not 64, that time. The time I am speaking about. That time only 50 mots you are establishing within this short period of time. Prabhupada laughing. 50 mots? What do you say? Actually, I wanted to establish Gauri Math inside the heart of all bonded souls. Everybody. 50 mots, what? You know, and you are speaking about 50 months. If I could get 50 personalities, gigantic personalities, yeah, fully dedicated soul, 50, then, you know, I think myself lucky. You are speaking about 50 months, eh? I am speaking about 50 mobile math, mobile Gaudiya Math. Those who are, you know, big, big, you know, excellent preacher, they are all dedicated soul. Already I told, those who are ready, always ready to sacrifice their life in the flame, glowing there in Siva Sangan, Sankirtan Jagyagni, those who are always ready to sacrifice their life in that fire of Sankirtan Jagya, they are actually actual preacher. They are actually a member of Gaudiya Math. Not that everybody and, you know, they are all preacher and member of Gaudiya Math, not that. So actually, Prabhupada wanted to get 50 mobile Gaudiya Math. Those are having ideal character, idealism, they have. They are going to accept all the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in toto. And then, Prabhupada speaking, then I am happy. Otherwise, you know, 50 maths I established, it is almost nothing. Yeah. It is almost nothing, actually. So, actually, before, you know, speaking anything about preaching, before speaking anything about the qualities of this preacher, I already started with this point, that Agasur, Bakasur, Trinavartha, Kangsa, they are all preacher. They are preaching negative way. They are preaching negative way, negative preaching. Why? Because they are, you know, creating one incident, and by that, massive preaching going on. But that is actually negative preaching. They want to kill Krishna. They want to... This way actually, this is called actually negative preaching. And positive preaching, actual positive preaching, can only be done by all those Vrajavasis. What do you mean by preaching? Preaching means to give bhakti, to install bhakti into the heart of bonded soul. This is called preaching. I already give example during Bhagavad discourse, that time in Purushottam Vrata, that Malini singing and dancing sometime in, you know, plucking flower there in garden and making garland, because she is going to shell this market and somehow she like to maintain one life. Malini, she is dancing and singing and plucking flowers and making garlands. That time actually, those Jagik Patnis, those were the wives of all Jagik Brahmana, they have had the chance to hear the song of who? As Malini. This way, they hearing the song of Malini, immediately it catch their heart. They are waiting long time to meet with Krishna. Krishna Darshana Lala Saha. They are waiting to see. So Malini actually you cannot speak that Malini is a big preacher. But we can say Malini is a big preacher. Malini is a big preacher. Malini is a big preacher. Uddhav Prabhu wanted to preach in front of our Brajavasis. He discovered himself, I am foolish number one. Uddhav Prabhu wanted to preach in front of all Vrajavasis to stop their crying, but actually it was proved ultimately Uddhav could discover, I am foolish number one. So preacher, actually Uddhav is also preacher, not that Uddhav is not preacher. Otherwise, why, when Krishna going to disappear from this material world, in Prabhas Khetra, you know the spot Prabhas Khetra, when Krishna taking final preparation to leave this material world and go away from this material world. That time, somehow Uddhav crying and searching, where is my Prabhu? And somehow discover where? Prabhu is there under a banyan tree and sitting one leg, he is there after one leg and sitting like yogi. Then Uddhav coming in front of Supreme Lord, and by chance Maitreya Muni also, as a disciple of Vyasadeva, also by chance coming. By chance is a pre-arrangement, not by chance. So both of them waiting, because Krishna going to give them lesson about Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan Mukta Sangasya Pariyayate. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, you cannot go to a Bhagavat school and memorize some, get some dry tattva, not that. Otherwise, why it is written in, you know, Shastra, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyanam Mukta Sangasya. Eh? Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, you cannot know. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, you can know from a Mahabhagavat. So, both of them, as Maitreya Muni and Uddhavji waiting, because Krishna going to give final advice, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. So, Krishna now speaking, after Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan is what? Very secret Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. You know, Uddhavji Maharaj and Maitreya Muni, both of them, getting this Tattva Vigyan by the mercy of Krishna. And after that, when Krishna taking final preparation to leave this material world, then Uddhav crying lies, you know, bursted into tears like mad. Oh, Prabhu, without you I cannot live. Please take me also with you. Prabhu said, no, if you love me, it is your duty to follow what I say. You have to carry out my order. So that time we know, we have evidence that Krishna going to make Uddhav a great preacher. Not that. That time, Bhagavan says, when Uddhav crying, I like to, for without you cannot, I cannot live. Krishna is doing, no, you have to live in this material world. I like to make you Acharya. I like to make you Acharya. Who is going to accept? Who is going to digest all Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan? Without digestion, how you can vomit? Vomit means? It's not digested. you cannot digest. So, Uddhava, Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to make Uddhava a great preacher, Acharya. So, this way, actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Uddhava, Uddhava, you will have to stay in this natural world as a number one Acharya. You will have to stay here because you have to preach. You have to speak. You have to speak about me, preach. You will have to give, distribute bhakti. So, in one sarup, you can stay in Badhigasram. In one sarup, you can stay in Badhigasram. In another sarup, you can stay in Udhapkunda. Udhapkunda, they are in Vrindavan. Both sarup. Actually, why both sarup? Why not Maharaj, one single sarup? Has some reason. Actually, Uddhava Prabhu going to Badhigasram. Bhadigasaram, STT and Finance is doing, and by his power, he is going to give us kripa. Like Naro Narayan Prabhu, it is written in Bhagavatam, Naro Narayan, no other than Supreme Lord Himself. But in Bhagavatam, it is written, Naro Narayan, they both of them, they are kalpanta tapasya, all kalpa, kal, they are doing tapasya. For, why? To give some benefit, to give kripa. So much sinful activities going on around that Vyasadeva and Naranaran Prabhu Uddhavji, they are doing some, and they are praying for us. They are praying for us in front of Supreme Lord. Vaishnavera Abedana Krishna Dayamoy, Yano Pamarpati Haiven Sada. But I am bound to speak this way that Uddhav is a great preacher. Uddhav is a great preacher actually. Why? Just now you told that the Brajavasis are excellent preacher. Why you are speaking this way? Well, I want to explain from Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami was speaking. Well, I told you the actual fine. If you think very secretly, you will have to go through this tattva, you can realize that actually to get the excellent thing, you have to get the association of Brajavasis. To get the actual thing, secret thing, Brajorasa Tattva Vigyan, you will have to get the association of those Brajavasis. Uddhav cannot, actually, but still Uddhav is a great preacher. Why? Because Uddhav can give bhakti to us. Not Brajoprema, actually. Uddhav can give bhakti to us. And actually, in Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami was speaking, at all if you like to go for preaching, first of all you have to see, you have to check up your quality. At all if you are fit for that purpose, then you can go, otherwise don't go. I can give some example one by one. Actually Jiva Goswami was speaking, at all if you like to go for preaching, you will have to take shelter of Vaidhi Bhakti. At all, if you are going for preaching, at all, if you like to go for preaching, at all. Suppose you are approved by your Gurudev, maybe you are having some excellent qualities. Still, Jiva Goswami was speaking, though you are going for preaching, but still, actually you will have to take shelter of Vidhi Marg, first, primary. You cannot go for preaching, And Ragmarg. Ragmarg is not a matter of preaching. Ragmarg, you're going to go in market and you cannot speak. There is so much instruction I can speak you in front of you. But actually, Jiva Goswami was speaking, if you, at all you are going for preaching, then you will have to, you know, take the help of Vidhi Marg. Then you can go for preaching. It's primary, you have to do it. And otherwise, actually, all other qualities like, you know, 100% inclined you are, 100% giving tattva vigyan you are having, all nice, you know, tattva vigyan. In that case, different kinds of categories there, even madhyam adhikari can go for preaching. Actually, madhyam adhikari can go for preaching. Just now I told Uddhav is number one preacher. Why? Uddhav can go for preaching and install bhakti inside the heart of everybody. Hello? Uddhava. And finally, I would like to say, in Bhagavad glorification, you can find all those wives of Krishna, those who are not, you know, those who are going to stay in this matter, that time also. Then finally, they heard Bhagavatam from Uddhava. That was also one kind of excellent preaching. All, you know, all the wives of Krishna, those, some wives, they already disappear. You can remember, Mahishi Haran. Mahishi Haran mean, oh, those are Mahishis, they actually disappear. Krishna, I actually give instruction to Arjun. Arjun finally will have to guide them. But where Arjun, in the midway, you find some coal wheel and some tribal people fighting with Arjun. Arjun defeated fully, and all Mahishi Haran, all Mahishis, they take away. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction, actually, Mahishi Haran, all those Mahishis disappeared in front of Arjun. It was one kind of actually, what thing? Actually, excellent thing. It's Maya, Jogamaya. Krishna disappear, and Mahishi Haran, both actually done by Jogamaya. Actually, Arjun can never be defeated by anybody, but still defeated. So it is written, it is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Sanatana, actually Mahishi Haran, and you know, this Krishna's disappearance, all done by Jogamaya. So, usually, Uddhava is a big preacher. Uddhava is preaching very nice way, but now you can find Uddhava when speaking in Uddhava Kunda, Uddhava Kyari, and speaking in front of those Mahishis, those who are there. In that case, Bhagavad Katha, Uddhava speaking. By that Bhagavad Katha, they all those, you know, wives of Krishna and all of they are going to get some excellent tattva, rasa tattva. So Uddhava Prabhu acting both way actually. Now Bhagavan actually Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, "Ho my Guru Varga," in front of all devotees, I mean disciples, our Guru Varga, Prabhupada giving final instruction before sending them for preaching. Prabhupada speaking, "Oh my Guru Varga, always try to remember this thing, that I was greatly moved, I was attracted by my Gurupad Padma Gaur Kishar Babaji Maharaj. How? By the quality Tinadavisunich sloka. Tinadavisunich no? Tarabhisayasuna, amanina manadana, kittaniya sadahari. Kittaniya sadahari mean, you can sing the glories of Krishna, but before that, you will have to follow this sloka, finally. So, tinadubhisunich, tararubhisayasuna. Tinadubhi mean, Prabhupada speaking, you will have to become humbler than the blade of grass. Why? But if you are not humbler than the blade of grass, suppose you are like grass, then some horse, some ass, you know, they can eat you up. Grass, those horse, you know, they are grazing there. If some, you know, grass is little bit high, then they have the chance to eat up. That's why we should become humbler than the blade of grass, you know. You become humbler than the blade of grass, then there is no chance that some horse or ass can eat you up. No, not possible. So, humbler than the blade. Tinadubhi sunichino. Tararopi sahishuna, tararopi mani. And you have to more forbearing than trees. Trees, why? Krishna, actually, Prabhupada, giving this, giving explanation, Bhaktivinod Thakur in Bhajan Rahasya speaking, "Briksho yano kathilo kichuna boloi, Sukaya moile kare panina mangai, jeja mangwe ter dei upon thon, gormovishti swahe aner koroe rakshan. Actually, Bhaktivinod Thakur giving explanation in Bhajan Rahasya that one devotee should be more forbearing than trees. Because why? Because trees never going to ask any water from anybody. Suppose in, you know, Jyeshtha Mas, Vaishakh Jyeshtha, that time scorchy sunlight, still a tree never going to ask you, give me some water, I am thirsty, not that. Sukaila mohine kare panina mangai. And anybody coming in front of any tree, going to give flower, fruits, even wood, you know, leaf, anything, what he like to collect, he can collect without any, you know, any problem. Because trees not going to put one objection in front of you. Why? It's for more forbearing, you see, this quality. Now actually, trees not going to ask anything from you, going to, suppose you are going to cut the trees itself, cut one big branches. Still, that man going to take rest in the noontime, 2 o'clock, so high sunlight, hot, then that man who is going to cut that tree itself, going to take rest under the tree. This that tree not speaking, you just, you know, going to cut me, why you are taking rest? Here, and I'm a sarah, not speaking. So this way Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining, so Trinadabhi Sunichana Tararupi Sahishnuna, this way, you know, Tararupi Sahishnuna, Amanina Manodino Kirtaniyosa, Amanina Manodino. Amanina Mani, you are not at all interested about material honor, any kind of honor. Any kind of honor and respect shown by anybody, you are not going to accept it. I mean, your heart not going to touch it. That is called Vaishnavi Patishtha. You know already? Vaishnavi Patishtha, Tate Karanishtha, Tahana Kulile, Lobibe Rourav. Prabhupada speaking, if you are less interested about Vaishnavi Patishtha, if you are not going to show honor to Vaishnavi Patishtha, then you are going to hell. Vaishnavi Patishtha, Tate Karanishtha, Tahana Kulile, Lobibe Rourav. Rourav means hell. So if you are not going to show honor to Vaishnavi Patishtha, be sure you are going to hell. Why? Because Vaishnavi Patishtha is an excellent thing. How you know that Srila Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj having Vaishnavi Patishtha, Parambhya Keshav Goswami Maharaj having Vaishnavi Patishtha, how you know? How we can realize? Vaishnavi Patishtha has some excellency that Vaishnavi Patishtha cannot touch you. So, how to realize that he is having Vaishnavi Patishtha? Who is having Vaishnavi Patishtha? Actually, Vaishnavi Patishtha means when you become perfect Vaishnava. When you become a perfect Vaishnava, I mean when you are going to follow your Paramahansa Gurudev in toto, I already told that the other day I was speaking, Prabhupada speaking this way, that actually to serve my Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma, to serve my Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma, if I need to go to hell, with due contact, I am always ready to go to hell. Still, I am not going to stop my seva of my Guru Pad Padma, Paramahansa Gurudev. So, this should be the mood. You can remember, the other day I was speaking about Kuresh. You know Kuresh? Kuresh is number one, you know, disciple of Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya is the number one preacher, disciple is Kuresh. Kuresh enjoying full kippa of Ramanujacharya. Actually, I told you that day that Kuresh, in the uniform of Ramanujacharya, went to Krimikanta, one dangerous, you know, king there in South India. Krimikanta, who is a Saiva. He went to preach Shaiva cult and he find it's dangerous. Actually, Ramanujacharya is most powerful. His preaching, his power is so, you know, so we cannot preach, you know, Shaiva cult. So he wanted to attack Ramanujacharya negative way, he wanted to kill Ramanujacharya, but then he wanted to send one, you know, messenger, some messengers. They are coming, hooligan. They are coming and speaking, who is Ramanujacharya? A Krimikanta calling you, right now you have to go with us, otherwise forcefully we can take you there. Then Kure's find is dangerous. They can attack our Gurupath Padma. Then Kure's took decision to identify himself as Ramanujacharya. I am Ramanujacharya. You are? Then you have to come with us. Then with them, Kure's going in the uniform of Ramanujacharya, danda in uniform. That time Kure's was Brahmachari, not Sannyasi. That time actually going, and Krimikanta actually in Sava, in open Sava waiting, and big fighting going on, actually that Soiva Pandit is, he want to defeat Kures by Shastra, you know, but Ramanujacharya went on, and actually Kures went on giving excellent Yukti, excellent, one by one. So ultimately that Pandit was defeated. So he was big Pandit in their, according to their own estimation, he was excellent Pandit, but actually not Pandit. But he is defeated, and that case actually Krimikanda took decision. It was actually a target. It was actually a target, final target, that if you are defeated by him, you will have to take shelter of him. If he is defeated by you, he will have to take shelter. This was the final goal. But actually, Krimikanta is dangerous, very big, you know, dangerous man. That time what happens? Actually, Krimikanta took decision to eradicate two ISS of Krimik. Actually, Krimikanta took decision to eradicate two ISS of Kures. They apply instrument and, you know, take out two ISS. Then blood coming out, flow of blood. Then Krimikanta, you know, Krimikanta throwing him out in street, road. Then Kures crying, oh Gurudev, oh Gurudev. This way crying, all bloods coming down. You cannot see. In that case, with the help of one Brahman, somehow reach in front of Gurudev. Gurudev crying, seeing the condition. What happens? Gurudev heard, this is the condition. You are actually disciples, number one. He is actually a disciple who is going to sacrifice his whole life for the cause of Gurudev. He is actually number one disciple. This kind of example was said by Kesab Goswami Maharaj. So, he is also Kuresh in our, you know, Siddhanta. In that case, by the mercy of Ramanujacharya, Ramanujacharya in front of Bharat Raj speaking, what happens, Prabhu? Then by the mercy of Bharat Raj, very shortly, Kures got Dibba Chakshu. Dibba Chakshu, you know? Transcendental eyes, Dibba Chakshu. Very shortly, Kures got back his Dibba Chakshu. Dibba Chakshu, you know? You know Dibba Chakshu? Like Mahabharata, actually, you know, Mahabharata fighting, you know. Sanjay waiting there in kingdom and giving commentary, lip telecast of that, you know, what is happening there in Kurukshetra, Yuddha, but he is there in front of Andha Dhritarashtra. He is the Gavalga Muni. Gavalga Muni is the son of Gavalga Muni. Who is Sanjay? What is the identity? He is the son of Gavalga Muni. Gavalga Muni, and by the mercy of Vasudeva, by the mercy of Vasudeva, this Sanjay getting Dibba Chakshu, so that he can see everything, what is happening there in Kurukshetra battlefield. Not only that, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna exhibiting it, you know, Vishwarup, Vishwamurti, Vishwamurti in front of Arjuna, all Vishwamurti, you know. Then also, Arjuna looking this Vishwamurti, and at the same time, Sanjay also looking this Vishwamurti. Why? Vyasadeva Goswami, by the mercy of Vyasadeva Goswami, is getting Dibba Chakshu. Materialize, by materialize you can get Akshaja Darshan, by Dibba Darshan, Dibba, if you have transcendental eyes, you can have Dibba Darshan. So, actually, Kure is already having Dibba Darshan. You can see clearly all everything. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj externally cannot see, almost blind. But Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj can see everything. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj can see everything, Dibba Chakshu. One day, night time, actually, almost 2 o'clock, when Prabhupada doing bhajan, Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj coming in Brajapattan, where you are speaking, that is Chaitanya Maharaj at present. That is called Chandrasekhar Acharya Bhavan, there, Prabhupada doing bhajan, that time, night time, 2 o'clock, actually, coming. Prabhupada said, how you come here? Who helped you to cross river? How you come? Night 2 o'clock. So dangerous actually. It's almost forest all around. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj not speaking anything, only laughing. Only laughing. Gaur Kishore Babaji only laughing. Not speaking anything. Then Prabhupada could realize it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga, helped him to cross river and come up to this way. It's impossible. A long way. How to come? Where is Ulorgat? From there it's impossible to reach Chaitanya Math, long way, almost forest actually, night time. This is called actually Dibba Chakshu. See, in one sense I would say, if you want to go for preaching, you should have one kind of Dibba Chakshu. Otherwise you cannot go for preaching. Now Prabhupada actually speaking, oh my Guru Bhargava, you see, I was attracted, I was moved by my Guru Bhargava, by my Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj. I was tremendously attracted by my Guru Padma. How? Because Guru Padma is showing his, these four vital qualities. One is Tinadapi, Suni, Taro Vishajma, Amanina Manadana, and Kit. Amanina Manadana. Amani means no kind of, no pratishtha not going to touch your heart. That is called Vaishnavi pratishtha. I can give example actually. So when any amount of pratishtha you are getting, actually you are not going to, that Vaishnavi pratishtha not going to touch your heart, then you are actually, it is called actually Vaishnavi pratishtha. What do you mean by Vaishnavi pratishtha? When you are actually perfect Vaishnava, totally, you are established in Vaishnava Asan. Rai Ramananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu discussing in front, at the bank of Godavari. You can remember. Rai Ramananda Sangbad going on. At the bank of Godavari Nadi River, that time Mahaprabhu asking in front of Rai Ramananda, Ramananda, actually, which pratishtha is excellent pratishtha, topmost? There, Rai Ramananda saying, Prabhu, who is famous as Vaishnava, is actually that pratishtha. That pratishtha is excellent. Not that he is a, president of America, he is a, prime minister of India. Not that pratishtha is, Raja Adhiraj, big king, as king going to give this kind of pratishtha. That is not actually topmost pratishtha. That time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove in front of Rai Ramananda, because actually Rai Ramananda Mahaprabhu putting question, Rai Ramananda giving answer. But Rai Ramananda speaking, you are actually speaking. I am actually instrument. You are actually speaking. So actually, Rai Ramananda speaking, who is famous as great Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, his pratishtha is excellent pratishtha, topmost pratishtha. Everybody, all those demigods, they are also searching this kind of big pratishtha. Vaishnava padam amananti. We also, Shankar Brahma is saying, we like to finally, get this seat, chair, Vaishnava pratishtha. So you understand, what is Vaishnava pratishtha? Vaishnava pratishtha means, any amount of pratishtha you are going to get, but that pratishtha not going to touch your heart is not contaminated by pratishtha, lava puja pratishtha, kana kakhamini pratishtha bagini chariya che jare sahito. Again, I come back to this point. Kana kakhamini, kanak mean, affluences, kana kakhamini, Kamini means Joshit. Kanaka Kamini, I mean Patishtha Jyotish, Kanaka I mean Patishtha Bhagini. Not going to touch you. In that case, we are sure that you are 100% perfect Vaishnava. In that case, Vaishnavi Patishtha Tatekara Nishtha Tahana Lodhuriya Ravivi Lourav. Vaishnavi Patishtha, Prabhupada writing. Vaishnavi Patishtha Tatekara Nishtha Tahana Karile Ravivi Lourav. So write this, you know, like mathematics. Actually, Prabhupada wants to prove that if you cannot become a perfect Vaishnava, then contamination is there. Someday you can fall down, big problem. So you will have to become a big Vaishnava. I mean, you will have to establish, get yourself established in Vaishnavasan. In that case, any kind of Patishtha coming in the life of, in your life, then it is called Vaishnavi Patishtha. All our Kesav Goswami Maharaj, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, you know, Bhaktivinod, they are all getting Vaishnavi Patishtha. So that Patishtha cannot touch you. You can pass, suppose somebody giving me Patishtha, I want to pass on this Patishtha to my Guru Padma. Guru Padma want to pass on this Patishtha to Prabhupada. Prabhupada want to pass on this Patishtha to Gaurakishwara Babaji Maharaj. Gaurakishwara want to pass on this Patishtha to Bhaktivinod Thakur. This way all Patishtha ultimately going to touch the lotus feet of Radharani, Rasa Tattva, Aspa Rasa Tattva. If you cannot go up to that one, then you can say, going to touch the lotus feet of Nityananda Balaram. Follow? This way actually, this is the definition of Vaishnavi Patishtha. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove, you know, that Vaishnava, that designation, this Patishtha, Vaishnavi Patishtha is topmost. Rayaramananda saying, Rayaramananda speaking in front of Mahaprabhu, Prabhu, actually who is famous as great Vaishnava, unique Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, his Patishtha is topmost. So, actually now point is that Vaishnavi Patishtha Tatekara Nishtha Tahalakuri Ravive Raurav. Those who are going for preaching, for them we like to give one example from Nilachal Lila, Purushottam Lila. When Mahaprabhu was there, Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami Pad, anybody coming to watch the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they usually taking shelter in the cell of Bhajan Kutir of Haridas Thakur. They are not coming anywhere. They think, we are fallen soul, we cannot go anywhere, we cannot stay with all other devotees, they are pure enough, we have no right to. That's why, any time Sanatana Goswami coming, Rupa Goswami, they are taking shelter there, where? In the cell Bhajan Kutir, solitary cell of Bhajan Kutir of Haridas Thakur, usually they. That time some discussion going on someday, now Haridas Thakur speaking, actually you are very lucky, all your, you know, Rupa, you, Sanatana and Rupa, all Jiva, all, you know, you are getting all excellent kipa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, from Prabhu, because Mahaprabhu giving instruction to you all, it is a standing instruction to you all, that you will have to discover the Lila Sthali, all excellent Lila Sthali of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, you have to discover, and also you have to compile Vaishnava Sriti. Vaishnava Sriti you will have to compile, Rasa Tattva you will have to, you know, establish everything through Shastra. So you are very lucky, actually. Then Sanatana Goswami was speaking, actually you are topmost lucky. Why? But actually, Nam, Harinam is, you know, more than Hari. Because Harinam is more than Hari. Harinam is more than Hari. Harinam is more than, that's why Hanumanji Maharaj writing name in big, big stone. Jai Siram, he writing. And catching and throwing into sea. And then, that, you know, stone floating, you know. This way, Ram, Ram Nam. So, name, Harinam is more than Hari. This way, actually, Haridas Thakur is Namacharya. Haridas Thakur is Namacharya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, you are Namacharya. You are actually doing name, Harinam, whole day and night, you are actually going to preach the excellency of Harinam. You are actually Namacharya. So Sanatana Goswami is speaking, actually you are topmost lucky. Among all the parshas of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are topmost. Why? Actually, Nam is more than Hari. So you are that Namacharya. So all day and night you are doing Harinam, and Sanatana Goswami is speaking, Prachar kare keho na kare achar, achar kare keho na kare prachar, achar pochar namer karoho dvikarjo, tumi sarva guru tumi jagater arjo. What Sanatana Goswami is speaking this way? What? But actually, Sanatana Goswami is speaking, somebody, they are following some Vaishnava etiquette. I mean, doing, you know, they are following bhajan, doing bhajan, everything, but they are not going for preaching. They are not going for preaching. Only they are doing bhajan and they are not going for preaching. Acharan is there. Because I already told, without acharan, your prachar is a part of karmanga, you are kormi. Those who are going for preaching without having any Vaishnavi patishtha, they are actually karmi. Actually, they are kormi. They are actually preacher, not preacher. So, Sanatana Goswami actually speaking, in front of Haridas Thakur, somebody only going for preaching, they are not following what they are speaking, acharan is not there, and somebody going for preaching with acharan. Achar kore, somebody doing acharan, but not going for preaching, somebody going for preaching, not doing acharan. But you are doing both. You are doing both. That is why that number one harlot, a fallen soul, that Chintamani Veshwa Pros was attracted by Haridas Thakur. How? Because of his Trinada Visunit Bhav. Follow. Haridas Thakur exhibiting this Trinada Visunit, Tarorva Saishno, Amanina Manada, Kitaniya Sadahari. Haridas Thakur chanting Harinam Trinada Visunit. He is more than the humble than the blade of grass. He is more forbearing than tree, doing Harinam with great, you know, power, and going to give honor to that pros also. You are coming, excuse me, I couldn't help you. I know the reason for why you are coming to get my association, but actually my name is not complete. Whole day and night I am taking, excuse me, never mind. His humble attitude. In that case, that pros, okay, maybe today not come, tomorrow you come, I can fulfill your heart. Again, that pros coming, again, Haridas Thakur begging for pardon. Excuse me, today also I couldn't, I am doing, taking nam day and night, but I couldn't, you know, actually 1 crore Harinam I am doing in 1 month. 1 crore, 1 crore Harinam I am doing in 1 month, and actually, excuse me, I am very sorry. Tomorrow, surely, I am going to fulfill your heart. Then, third day coming and hearing Harinam. Why I am explaining this soon? To prove some special qualities of a preacher. Very secret thing. I am coming one by one. So, Haridas Thakur doing Harinam. You can think, Haridas Thakur not going to America for preaching. So what? But Mahaprabhu speaking, all stabar jangam. Those are matters. And those are having pran, and the trees and, you know, insects, all benefited by the chanting of Harinam. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. When Haridas Thakur was speaking, the sound vibration going to touch our stavar jangam. Haridas Thakur, you know, disclosing this secrecy. When Mahaprabhu asking Haridas, you are giving some, you know, some glories of Harinam, but I wonder how is possible those trees and, you know, those hills can get benefit? Haridas Thakur, Prabhu, never mind. Actually, when you are speaking Harinam, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, then all your sound vibration going all around this material world. Not that you can think I am speaking lie. No. When you are speaking in America, how I can catch this word by mobile? Follow. Scientific evidence. Sound vibration going all around. Haridas Thakur speaking, Prabhu, when you are speaking Hare Krishna, the sound vibration going around. He strike with all hills and, you know, trees, they are getting benefit, Prabhu. They are getting benefit. You know, actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the excellent preacher. Even tigers and elephants, they are also doing Harinam. But to speak about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know the preaching mood of whom? Samananda Prabhu, Rasikananda Prabhu. Eh? That wicked, you know, Jamindar, you know, in by the invocation of that Jamindar, one, you know, invocation, you know, that mad elephant coming to kill Rasikananda Sikhine. Hey, for infinity life, expressing your madness. How long you can do? Stop now. Then the elephant crying, coming in from Rasikananda and stop. Yeah, yes, Rasikananda, in front of Rasikananda coming and both sit, then sitting. And Rasikananda giving Harinam in his ear. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. That elephant is initiated. Whereas we can deserve, Maharaj, I took initiation 30 years over, I am not getting any result. But that elephant, instant. The elephant? You see, that elephant, instant, got initiation from Rasikananda Prabhu. And up to his last moment of life, is doing service for Guru Vaishnava. I am not making any story. You can go through the life history, everybody knowing. In Midnapur, everybody knowing. It's famous, you know. So elephant, you know, in front of elephant, Rasikananda Prabhu preaching. Preaching means installing bhakti. Installing bhakti inside the heart of that elephant, then that elephant, craziness gone, the elephant become gentleman. Gentle elephant, like gentleman sitting. And after his last moment of life, that elephant doing service, how? Going to forest and getting some dry log with tongue and coming for cooking. We need cooking, so we need wood. And sometimes there is no wheat, no rice, going to one place and getting some one or two, three, boom, I know, sack, putting it in. Who is going to forbid? His elephant. Oh, take, Ganesh. Is Ganesh coming? I can make more profit. Oh, Ganesh, you coming to take rice? Take. This way, wild rice, wheat, everything, ghee, chavad, everything. So big festival going on. You know, this way, that elephant actually doing service. So you know, this way actually, preaching means you will have the power, you must have the power to install bhakti inside a heart of bonded soul. I give example already, maybe in Purushottam Dham, I think, the other day I was speaking, how it was possible for common people to cry, whereas they don't understand the language of Narottama Thakur. When Narottama Thakur reaching Manipur, then Narottama Thakur sitting in the temple, one temple, Radha Govind's temple, and playing on kartal, nice, and doing kirtan, and shedding tears, all around, all thousands of people. They don't understand the language of, Narottama Thakur, because Narottama Thakur was singing in Bengali language, whereas they don't have any idea about Bengali language, but still they are shedding tears, crying. Pasupaki jure, pashan vidare sunijar gunugatha. Pasupaki jure, pashu, those beasts and birds, they are shedding tears, you know. Pashan vidare, stones going to be melted, you know, sunidar gunagatha, the glories of Gauranga is so excellent. This way, actually, now I like to come back to the point what Prabhupada wanted to speak. Prabhupada praying in front of all Guru, you are all my Guru Varga, I have some application in front of you, prayer. try to listen me very carefully. Actually, I was, you know, very much attracted by my Guru Padma because he wanted to show his four qualities. Tinadabhisunich, just now I told Haridas Thakur, it is quite impossible for you to preach in front of that harlot. You know? Quite impossible. But Haridas Thakur was capable. Haridas Thakur doing Harinam, and that Harinam, transcendental Harinam, that cross, you know, catching through his ears. One day, 2 days, 3 days, his heart, you know, Cheta Darpana Marjanam Bhava Madhavi. Through Sankirtan, you can, you know, clean your heart. 100%? Through Sankirtan, exact Sankirtan, you can clean your heart. Through Sankirtan. So now that harlot, you know, all, you know, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, harlot changing his mind. His heart totally clean. Totally clean. Then Haridas Thakur speaking, I know the reason for why you came here, but still, to save you, I was bound to stay here. I was bound to stay here to deliver you. Oh, really? A harlot speaking all the, you know, planning of, you know, of that Ramchandra Khan. Wicked Ramchandra. Haridas Thakur, I know everything. To deliver you, I am waiting here for 3 days. First day, I was supposed to go away. I thought how to deliver you, so I am staying. So now you are delivered. You go on doing Harinam, Sankirtan, 3 lakh Harinam. Continuously you do, and you put this Tulsi is there. Tulsi, you do Tulsi Parikrama, give water, give the nourishment of Tulsi Devi, and chant in front of Tulsi Devi, you can come out successful. Now I am leaving this place. Now Haridas Thakur leaving this place. So Haridas Thakur is not number one preacher. Not Haridas Thakur number one preacher. Haridas Thakur number one preacher because that frost, that harlot was totally attracted by the qualities of Haridas Thakur. Totally attracted by the qualities of Haridas. What qualities? Four important qualities, mainly. A Vaishnava can have countless qualities. But four special qualities, Prabhupada speaking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction, and by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am also going to speak the same way. So, that harlot, I mean that prose, was totally, you know, influenced by Haridas Thakur, totally attracted. By what kind of quality? Trinada Visunij, Haridas Thakur, humble at the end of red Aukas. All is humble. Now, one misconception can have. You can have some misconception that Trinada we mean powerless. You can think so. Those material people, they think Trinada we mean he is powerless, that's why he is showing Trinada. Not that. Not that. You can think he is showing Trinadavi because he is without any power, he is powerless. Not that. Trinadavi means most powerful. His Trinadavi Baba can give some, is one kind of fire inside. Outside you can find, is no power. Haridas Thakur, they are going to beat Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur, suffering. Very humbly. Oh, in 22 different markets, those Muslim people, you know, they're going to beat Haridas Thakur, but still Haridas Thakur not going to lose his patience. Why? No. Humbler than the blade of grass and more fearing, more forbearing than a tree is totally applicable in the life of Haridas Thakur. In one market, if somebody beat you, whip, you can die. Haridas Thakur, 22 markets, but still praying, oh Prabhu, they don't know what kind of, you know, thing they are doing. Please excuse them. They are ignorant, actually, Prabhu. Huh? They are ignorant. Murhero mongol tumi anneshibe. I am actually ignorant. So, Guru Vaishnava, you will have to search out my, you know, benefit. My good, you will have to search. Murheno mongol tumi aneshi. Murho mean ignorance, full of ignorance. I cannot find my, I cannot search and find out my own good. So Guru Vaishnav can find, give some benefit. This way actually, now Haridas Thakur, by these four qualities of Haridas Thakur, that frost, Lakshahira, was, you know, very much attracted. Very much attracted. Poba speaking, my Guru Padpatmo catch me, my pull me like magnet by showing these four qualities. Poba speaking, believe me, my Guru Padpatmo Guru Kishadas Baba, you know, as and when I reach his lotus feet, he catch me like magnet. I was attracted by, you know, by Guru Kishadas Baba, Babaji Maharaj. He was kind enough to exhibit four, you know, important qualities as was instructed by Mahaprabhu. Srinath Viswanich. He wanted to prove that as if he is nothing. You know, Haridas Thakur. Actually, Prabhupada speaking, actually, even demigods, they are not out of false ego. Even those demigods, they are not out of false ego. If they are at all out of false ego, where they are, why they are making so much problem? Indra. Indra making so much problem, you know. And they are not actually, no demigods. Actually, about Shankar Bhagavan, it is written, but still it is very important, I am going to speak about the Tattva of Shankar Bhagavan, Sivaratri. That day I can explain. About only Shankar Bhagavan, it is written, Nimna Ganam Yatha Ganga Devanam Achyuto Yatha Vaishnavanam Yatha Sambhu Purananam Purananam Tuidam Bhagavatam. Only for Shankar. All other demigods there, they are not having 100% humble attitude. You know the incident from Katha Upanishad? Yeah? I already told you, you can forget. That to test Indra Maharaj and all demigods, Brahma, Purna Brahma Vastu came in the gate of Sarga and in the form of Jaksha, some special, you know, form. Nobody can, who is he? Nobody can answer. Somebody coming in front of Indra, giving information. Oh, special, strange. Some creature, you know, coming in front of Sarga gate. Who? Well, I don't know. You go and ask who? Then Agni Devata came, Varun Devata came, first Pavan Devata came. Pavan Devata came and asking, who are you? Then Brahma asking, who are you? He is asking, who are you? He asked, who are you? Actually, my name is, you don't know. I am your Pavan Dev. Pavan Dev, who is he? What is your identity? Who you are? You don't know. My name is Pavan Dev. Pavan Dev, who is Pavan Dev? My name is Pavan Dev. You don't know. Strong wind, you know, I can take everything, you know, cross everything by a strong wind. So much powerful I am. Really? Oh, I have one piece of straw. You can, you know, you try to fly. Then full energy, full power, applying full power. Pavan Dev was not able to move. Not even move. What to speak about, you know, move that straw, piece of straw. What happens? Actually, it's a new case. Never before in my life happened so. So he gone in front of Indra. What is identity? I don't know. I was actually, it's excellent thing. I went to ask him, he said, who you are? Then I giving my name is Pavan Dev. I used to, what is your power? I can fly, you know, destroy everything. So strong wind power. And even one piece of straw, I couldn't move. So much weak I am. Really? Then Indra Maharaj is saying, Barun Dev, Barun, you are most powerful. You go. And try to find the identity. I try to know. Then after that, what happens? Barun Dev coming. Who you are? Who you are? My name is Pavan, my name is Barun Dev. By water force, I can, you know, inundate the whole world. I can destroy everything. Oh, really so? You are so powerful. Yeah. Oh, really? That you can, you know, this piece of straw is there. You can throw by your water power. You know, you are so powerful. Couldn't do anything. After that, gone back to Indra Maharaj. Maharaj, it's so strange in my whole life. No, such incident, you know, first time. What happens? Actually, I couldn't identify who the man is. He is asking who you are. I told him, I am Varundev. He wanted to test my, you know, power. I was failure. Then Agnidev. Yo, Agni, you are the youngest of all. Come, go. And try to know the identity. Then what happens? Agnidev come. And they were, who you are? Who you are? My name is Agnidev. I can burn up everything. Really? So powerful. Yes. My name is Agni. Everybody fear me. And now you try to burn up this straw piece, applying full power, that Agnidev was failure. Totally failure. That time what happens? Indra was fed up. Indra wanted to know himself. Oh, you're actually foolish. You cannot let me go myself. When Indra coming that place, that Jaksha, the special, you know, Brahma, Purna Brahma himself, vanished. Where is that, you know, Jaksha? Is vanished. Vanished? How I can know that? Then Umadevi, Vishuddha, Umadevi appear. You know, Gyan Sarupini Uma, Haimavati. Hey Indra, who? Actually, what you are searching? I am searching that, you know, a special, you know, feature of that. Actually, is Parabrahma. Parabrahma, yes, coming in form of Jaksha, small, to test you. Test me? Yes. You are puffed up, you know. You are fighting with all demigods, and adult demigods, they are fighting with demons. They think we are successful. We are in a major victory. We are actually powerful. To prove that you have no power, that Parabrahma came in this form. Really? Yes. Don't try to express any kind of false ego. You have no power. It is by the power of Parabrahma you are coming out successful in the fighting with Asura. Who you are? You know, Krishna already proved. Arjun speaking in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj. Oh Rajan, what? Why you are crying? Oh Rajan, everything lost. What lost? You are so powerful. Ah yes, that Gandiva, that bow and arrow is there with me. That Arjun is there. That technique is there with me. But I am totally failure today. My power taken away by Krishna. Oh really? Krishna crying in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj when coming back from Dwarika. And Arjun crying. Yudhishthira, why crying? My power, everything. That Arjun is there. But I couldn't fight with those, you know, tribals. They're fighting with me. I'm defeated. All power gone. That bow and arrow is there. That Arjun is there. That technique is known. I'm there. But that power gone. Power taken away by Krishna. All power taken away. This incident, in the Katha Upanishad, we know all demigods, they are full of false ego. They are full of false ego. They have false ego. All demigods. Many times making mistake, Indra, insulting, you know, out of his false ego, insulting Devaguru, Gurudev, Brahaspati, insulted this way. So many things I can explain. Actually, false ego, if false ego is there, you should not go for preaching. Kanishtha Adhikari cannot go for preaching. Madhyam Adhikari, if at all, except Madhyam Adhikari. Madhyam Adhikari, excellent quality, having some excellent quality, then he can go for preaching. Because preaching means you have to install bhakti. So now Prabhupada, I can explain next day also. Next day, but fifth I can discuss about that, you know, Siva Tattva, and on 7th I can discuss about Parame Bhakti to Madhav Goswami Maharaj. After that I can go on. So Prabhupada actually speaking, I was, you know, attracted by my Guru Pad Padma big way. Because my Guru Pad Padma, why? He shown me four qualities. Trinadavi Sunich, you think Trinadavi mean very weak, not that. Those who are Trinadavi, those who are pure Vaishnava, you think they are very weak. You can think they are very weak, not that. Very powerful. Inside them, so spiritual fire is there, so powerful, they can do anything. By their power, they can do everything. What they cannot do? What they cannot do? Abhisham can do anything. If Haridas Thakur want to destroy this world, can destroy. If Haridas Thakur want to create a new world, can do. Not that? Yes or not? Yes. Actually, I can give you one reminder that actually Pradyumna Mishra, Nishingananda Brahmachari, when Mahaprabhu wanted to go to Vrindavan, that time Nishingananda was sitting in asan and, you know, doing Harinam by nicely, meditate on the lotus feet of. Then, mentally, he is making all nice water ponds and flower gardens and road without any trouble so that Prabhu can go without any trouble. No stone. No stone, all flowers, you know, falling. And road is full of flower. If Prabhu going, Hare Krishna, Prabhu going, no stone can touch the lotus feet of Prabhu. Yes? After that, Nishingananda speaking, this time I am 100% sure, Prabhu not going to Vrindavan. Why? Why you pass this comment? Because my mind not going further. Why? Up to Kanai Natsala. Up to Kanai Natsala, one place in Bihar and Urisha border. My mind not going. I am 100% sure, Prabhu this time not going to Vrindavan. Oh, sure, yes. So Prabhu going to Kanai Natsala, come back to Bengal. Follow? So this way, one Vaishnava can do everything by Nama, Nambal, Chitbal, Nambal. You can think he is so weak. No! A Vaishnava is not so weak, most powerful. He's so powerful that you cannot stand. About Vaishnava, it is written in Shastra, Banhi Suryo, Banhi, so Banhi mean fire. Banhi mean Banhi, Banhi mean Sanskrit word, Bengali also. Banhi mean fire. Suryo means sun god. Banhi Suryo, Brahmanibhyo, Vaishnava, Tejiyan Vaishnava Sada. What is written in Shastra? Don't try to play with Vaishnava. Reason. Banhi. Better you can play with fire. You can play with sun god. But don't play with Brahm, you know, Vaishnava. Because Banhi, Suryo, Brahmanibhyo, Tejiyana Vaishnava Sada, most powerful. So now Prabhupada praying. Oh my Guru Bhargava, I was greatly moved. I was shocked to see all the qualities of my Guru Pad Padma, Paramahansa, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. So, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction, and also I am going to give you this instruction according to the instruction of my Guru Pad Padma. I myself want to get established in Tattva, I mean Trinadavi, also I am going to pass on this instruction of my Guru Pad Padma to you, so you have to follow. First of all, you have to become Trinadavi, Sunich, and Tararubha Saishuna, and never try to get any Pratishtha from anywhere. No smell of Pratishtha should be there inside your heart, then you can go for preaching, otherwise not. Be careful. Then you can go for preaching. No smell of Pratishtha is there inside your heart. All what you are doing for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. My Harikatha is not my Harikatha. My Harikatha is not an instrument to collect some lap puja patishtha from you all. Next day I can discuss after 7th. If any Harikatha going on then. My Harikatha is not an instrument to collect some money and honor from you all. My Harikatha is 100% servitorship of my Guru Varga. My Harikatha mean, I am speaking Harikatha mean, I am the servant of 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 my Guru Prabhupada. This my mood. Believe me, my Harikatha is not an instrument to collect some lap puja patishtha. Be careful. I am trying to implement the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Only this thing. I am going to carry out the order of my Guru Padma. That is my only. Nothing and no desire there. You can, you know, I can cut my heart and show you, like Hanumanji. Hanumanji cutting heart. So, what is there? Only Ram. Nothing there. Eh? If Ram is there, Ram means we think Balaram. If Ram is there, they should not be calm. If Ram is there, calm cannot be there. Any kind of smell of karma should not be there. Otherwise, don't go for preaching. Why? That I can explain next day. Why? Negative point also. And what kind of instruction Prabhupada giving to those who are interested to go for preaching? Full instruction. Day by day, I can discuss this point. Today, time is very limited. If you have any question, then you can put in front of me. And otherwise, you know, vāñca-kalpa-darvasya-kepa-sindhu-bhya-vaśya-patitānaṁ-pāvana-bhavishna-bhyo-nama-nama. If you have any kind of, if you have any question, no? Any question? One by one, I can say, why Mahābhāgavatū, medium, soft, everything. And preacher, who can become a great preacher, who can come out successful, who cannot come out successful, who can fall down if you forcefully go for preaching? I can explain one by one, with illustration. But on 5th, not 5th, actually Shiva Tattva, and on 7th, Madhav Goswami Maharaj, and after that I can try.